Hey everyone, welcome to the first episode of From the Field Q&A with P&J. My name is Pedro.
And I'm John. Let's dive into some questions that we've recently received. Pedro, how about you start off with the first one?
So our first question, user Ryan Sky, aka Tony on GitHub, asks, which DB vendor is used by Directus Cloud itself?
Great question, Tony. And Ben actually answered this in the thread itself. Ben is our CEO. In the cloud, we use Postgres, unless you're talking about Community Cloud, which is currently SQLite. That may change in the future in regards to Community Cloud, but in Enterprise and Standard, we do use Postgres. All right, great question, Tony. Let's look on to the next one.
Okay, so on to the next question. Is there a way I can migrate everything from one Directus Cloud instance into another Directus Cloud instance?
Yeah, there's actually a schema sync utility. We also give you that capability in command line interface, CLI. Those are both enabled on Enterprise Cloud, so that is something that you can do as well. Also, if you're migrating from one project to another, whether it be Community to Standard, Standard to Enterprise, we will also do that migration for you.
Mm-hmm. And you can you can find information on the schema sync utility in our Directus docs online.
That's actually a great question that ties into our next question, Pedro. How do I migrate a dev environment to a production environment?
Yeah, so same thing. We have the schema migration tool, which is a CLI integration, and we've got an API wrapper actually coming pretty soon here.
That's a good point too. We also allow you to have dev environments, non-production environments, as well as production environments, and seamlessly move information schemas in between the two. That's kind of where that version locking comes into play, where Pedro mentioned last question.
So for the final question, we have a lot of customers in Europe who ask to be compliant with GDPR regulations and ask where our servers are actually hosted.
Yeah, that's a great question. We do have several servers in GDPR compliant areas. For our standard cloud, we have an East US location, we have Asia location, and we also have servers in Frankfurt, Germany. So for standard cloud, you're covered under GDPR in Frankfurt, Germany. When you move up to Enterprise Cloud, we have a bunch more locations. Some of those include London, Stockholm, Paris, and I believe there's even one in Ireland, all of those which are enabled for GDPR as well. So plenty of locations available for those who are GDPR aware.
Yeah, and in addition to that, it's all based on Amazon AWS infrastructure, so highly performant and secure as well. Thanks so much for tuning in to From the Field Q&A with P&J. Make sure to smash that like button and subscribe for notifications on our future videos.
And feel free to ask questions in the comments. We're definitely going to take some of those questions for future episodes. We love answering community questions. And don't forget to join the communities on Discord and GitHub as well. That's where we also source questions from. Thanks again. Everyone have a great day.